The Greeks, like many peoples, decorated the graves of relatives with tombstones. This tombstone in Glencairn's collection shows a family scene, and family scenes were very common on tombstones in classical Athens. It's inscribed, so we know the name of the deceased. Her name is Nikobule, and she's shown seated on a chair, shaking hands with an older man, most likely her father, while her mother poignantly puts a hand on Nikobule's shoulder. The ancient Greeks had a lot of different views about the afterlife. Perhaps the most common is what we see from Homer and other sources, this view that in the afterlife, people who've died experience Hades, a bland, gray, boring place where the dead are pretty ineffectual. There are other views of the afterlife, but in general, what you did in this life really didn't affect your fate in the afterlife. So what you wanted in this life was to live in ways that you would be remembered. While there were views that somebody who died might be in the afterlife, there was also a thought that they might really be present at the grave too. And so offerings were left to continue that relationship in life. Glencairn has a number of small pottery vessels known as lekythoi, which were very typical of the type of thing that Athenians in the classical period and other periods would offer to the dead. These small vases that could hold liquid like oils or perfume. This tombstone is in the shape of one of these vessels, the type of tombstone that might be at a family grave in classical Athens. Maybe it's a farewell scene. Maybe it's also just commemorating a family connection, the family together, despite the death of Nikobule.